What's up, Meta Nerds? This video is all about the Haven-class medical station, simply known as Republic Medical Stations. Manufactured by Ventex Construction Yards, a joint company operated by Kuat Drive Yards, the creator of the Star Destroyers, Corellian Engineering Corporation, who made the CR-90, and Rendili Star Drive, who produced the Dreadnought-class heavy cruiser. This massive station was 651.84 meters in diameter, or 2,139 feet, making it about half the length of the Venator-class Star Destroyer, and more than twice as long as the Pelta-class frigate. It only required a crew of 150, but thousands of organic and droid doctors and nurses were needed to care for the upwards of 80,000 patients that could fill this medical station. Logistics to run this facility are pretty incredible, requiring tons of Olympic-sized swimming pool amounts of fresh bacta to be used daily, with the over 60,000 individual bacta tanks that were split up over the 8 main medical bays. Pelta-class frigates and various shuttles would be constantly offloading new wounded troops, activity which was all coordinated via this control hub at the top of this central tower. And to make sure it was in the most difficult to attack part of the station, the main reactor which fueled all of the Haven was located in the middle of this central structure. To help with repairing and understanding clone biology, these ships were usually overseen by Kaminoans, making it one of the rare times that you could see this secretive species without traveling to their watery homeworld. The first of these stations was established near the Kaleida Nebula, located at coordinates 017 on the galactic map, making it very close to Naboo. By being positioned near this massive and dangerous nebula, the medical station had a natural barrier to attacks, a decision that ended up saving the lives of 60,000 troops. When General Grievous tried to use the Subjugator-class heavy cruiser the Malevolence to destroy this facility, he had to navigate around the nebula. The smaller BTL-B Y-Wings of Shadow Squadron were able to just barely make it through, buying them enough time to regroup and damage the Malevolence enough to force Grievous to flee. To fully appreciate just how devastating this event could have been, consider the fact that the Battle of Jabim, which was considered to be one of the Republic's bloodiest losses in the Clone Wars, with upwards of 10,000 clone lives lost. In just a few minutes, the massive Malevolence could have caused at least 6 times the losses at Jabim. Another point of reference, the total injured clones from the first Battle of Geonosis was 20,000, and we all saw how violent that was. So a single medical station could heal up to 3 times the amount of clones that were injured during the opening Battle of the Clone Wars. Knowing that the Pelta-class medical frigate had a relatively fast Class 2 hyperdrive, and that there was a network of these medical stations across the galaxy, with other known locations in the Felucia system, and Ord Cestus, and you can see how the Haven-class was the literal lifeline of the Republic war effort. So that's it for its history, and the only really cool behind-the-scenes fact is that these stations were designed so that when viewed from above, it ends up making the Republic logo. So that's it for the Haven-class medical station. But most important of all, remember, the Kalish don't have a word for war crimes, and the Force will be with you. Always.